I'm here today to talk about the Rotary Trumpet. The Rotary Trumpet is the standard instrument in Germany and Austria. If you grow up playing trumpet in those countries, you play one of these. They're also played for decades in large American orchestras in Chicago, Cleveland, New York, Boston, and more you're seeing them in colleges and even in smaller orchestras in the United States and throughout the world. Most of us, at least in the United States, grew up without a functional knowledge of what the rotary trumpet is, what the differences are besides the valves, and how to play them. So that's what this video will help you do. Get started on the rotary trumpet. Let's talk first about just the basic construction of a rotary trumpet and the differences it has from our regular piston trumpets. If you look at a piston trumpet, you can see the lead pipe goes into the tuning slide, goes around, and goes into the third valve slide. It's a fairly long stretch of pipe before you hit the valve section. The rotary trumpet is very different. If we look at the rotary trumpet, we see a 5-inch lead pipe, and immediately we enter the valve section. After you go through the valve section, you come out, there's the tuning slide, and you have the big bow. This has a huge effect on the response of an instrument and how it feels to play. It's something that is essential to how rotary trumpets sound and is the big difference between these two horns. Besides the obvious structural differences that I just showed you, there are some internal differences that aren't so obvious. The bore on a rotary trumpet is much smaller than on the standard B-flat or C trumpet, piston trumpet, narrower all the way through. And at the end, when you get to the bell is broader, the flare is broader, and the bell is bigger. So a C trumpet bell like this has about 1/4 inch more diameter than a piston C trumpet. This has a huge effect on how the instrument plays, how it feels to the player, and what it sounds like. One of the major differences in feel when you play a rotary trumpet is how it blows. I've always made the comparison that a rotary trumpet feels like a small sports car and a piston trumpet feels like a heavy-duty truck. Both of them have significantly different feels. I think a rotary trumpet is capable of a lot more subtlety and color change than the piston trumpet. You can't drive a rotary trumpet like you can push a piston trumpet. You have to change things. One of the most important things to do is how you use your air. Especially in the lower register, it's important to not press the rotary trumpet with too much air. On a piston trumpet, we can push hard in the lower register and really, really get our air to sound. The rotary trumpet can be overblown very quickly. And the way to counteract that is to, I think warm air, like you're fogging a mirror. Warm, hot air, like you're yawning or trying to fog a mirror, as opposed to blowing hard, fast air. That's important in getting good response in the lower register. One of the great things about a rotary trumpet is that you could actually push it and play it significantly louder than on a piston trumpet. The tonal spectrum of the piston trumpet remains the same throughout its range, whether soft to loud. The rotary trumpet changes colors quite rapidly from mellow in piano volume to white hot molten in fortissimo volume. So the color change, which is something we don't necessarily want on a piston trumpet, is something that's prized on the rotary. One of the first things people notice when they see a good rotary trumpet are these extra keys. You'll see our normal water key and then these two extra keys, and they wonder what they are. Let's talk about those. These are called, in German, Klappen, which means key. And each one of them has a certain function which helps us play in the upper register. Each one of these keys decreases the resistance and increases the accuracy of a series of notes in the upper register. This one is the B-flat key. It does a B-flat chord. High F, high B-flat, high D, high F. This one is the A key. So fourth space E, high A, high C-sharp, and high E. You open them when you want to play those notes. And this is called the Vienna C key, the Vienna C, Vina Seklappa. That one is an A-flat chord. E-flat, A-flat, C, and E-flat, all in the upper register. So if you can imagine certain orchestral excerpts that are hard, you can make them much easier and much more secure with the use of these keys. The most famous one is the Zarathustra call. So every time I want to play that high C, I just pop open this chord, this key, excuse me. Each one of these, as I said, does different ones. So imagine Beethoven 7. The first part of Beethoven 7 has probably 200 high A's in it, just in the first movement alone. And playing that with this key down increases your security, makes you feel better, sounds great. Almost like cheating. These are found on all rotary trumpets in varying degrees. Everybody has a spit valve, so you can always do the high B flat and the high D, but others are options. You can add the A, you can add the A flat, the Vienna C key. You can also do a B key, which would do a B major chord. Experiment with these and find how they work. You can use false fingerings to play them, or you can use them with regular fingerings, but you push them down as you go for the high note. Here's another example. From pictures in an exhibition. All these high notes become something you don't worry about so much. In Germany, if you were to play an orchestral audition, you have to play on the B-flat trumpet, and the required audition piece is the Haydn Concerto. Sounds crazy, but it's actually an easier piece to play on the B-flat rotary trumpet than it is on the B-flat piston trumpet. Let me demonstrate a couple of things why. First is flexibility. The rotary trumpet, probably because of its narrower bore and also with the smoothness of the valves, is a little bit easier to do trills on. So let me demonstrate one section of the Haydn with trills. I won't play through it, but I want to demonstrate how much easier the trills are. That F to G trill is very hard on a piston trumpet. It feels clunky, it's not smooth. But you can see how simple it is on a rotary. Also, in the Hummel Concerto, the G to A trill. Lastly, the recapitulation of the first movement of the Haydn Concerto with those leaps, F, A, C, B flat. Those can be trouble on a regular trumpet, but on the rotary with the extra keys, they become much more secure. Watch my fingers. Almost child's play. I think an important feature of playing a rotary trumpet is picking a good mouthpiece. When I bought my first rotary trumpet in Austria, I was playing on my standard mouthpiece, which was a Bach mouthpiece, and the trumpet maker said, "Why don't you try a couple of these, because it helps our horns sound the way we want them to sound." And I tried them, and they worked out. I play an Austrian mouthpiece, a Breselmeyer mouthpiece, that I think makes the trumpet sound more like it should. Smoother, warmer attacks, and better intonation. That doesn't mean you can't play it on your regular Bach, Yamaha, Schilke, whatever mouthpiece you play. I just think you should experiment and try out Austrian or European mouthpieces to see how they work. I find that it makes playing the rotary much more appealing. And I think the end result is we shouldn't want these horns to sound the same. And the mouthpiece has a lot to do with that. You want the horn to sound different. You want to achieve different colors. And having a different mouthpiece helps you do that. So experiment again. Try different mouthpieces and see what you come up with.